So it is officially my last hour of being 21. And honestly, I can definitely say that I'm ready.
I don't know, when I turned 20, I remember being terrified and absolutely sad because I'm like, I'm no longer a teenager anymore. And I feel like every time, at least when I was a teen, every time I said I was a teen, it gave me like a cushion as to why I'm not acting like an adult. And then when I turned 20, I'm like, shit, I have to act like an adult now. And I still feel that way, but I definitely was afraid to turn like, even like 21, because I'm like, I'm a year closer to 30, because in my eyes, I feel like 30 is ancient, but then everything from retrospect, I realized that 30 is not ancient at all. You know, I think that now that I'm 22, or will be in an hour, I just feel like I'm so ready for it. I'm starting to realize that each age that you turn, you learn so many valuable things that really change your life and that help you become a better person. And at the end of the day, that's all I ever want.
I remember when I was 20, I would be so like sad that I'm not 17 anymore, because 17, honestly, that was a great year, to be honest, for music and also my life, because that's when I first traveled abroad. But I always tell myself, like, 17-year-old me could not be able to afford the lifestyle I have now. So for example, 17-year-old me could not go to clubs. 17-year-old me could not be able to afford nice dinners at nice restaurants. And 17-year-old me could not be able to afford any of the clothes in my closet. I'm not saying this as if like I have like all high-end luxury stuff. It's simply because now I have a job and I have my own income and I can pay for things now.
And to relish the last 30, my god, come on Leia, you can do it. The last 32 minutes of my 21 years of life, I'm going to listen to Khalid's song 21, because this will be the last time I'll ever be able to listen to this song as a 21-year-old, so. Good morning, everyone! It is officially the day! I am officially 22, and today is the day that I celebrate my 22nd birthday! So, this morning, I woke up, and I heard some rustling outside my door for a little bit, but then, so then I got up after a phone call with my mom, and then, oh my god, guys, this is just, it's so crazy! Like, this is so cute! Like, look at these little stars! And then, we get a little balloon day here, and then, my cousin made me crumples, like, oh, this is just so cute. This is so adorable. And like, this is,
where's she?
Oh. You're so cute. Thank you again. Oh my god, this makes me so happy. I'm so happy. Oh my god, what a great start to the day. Look, it's a rose. How cute is that?
Okay, so this is what I'm gonna be wearing today. So these are like white pants I got, I think from, I want to say Ann Taylor, I don't really know. And then this blazer I got from Zara, it's super cute. I've been wanting to wear it. It's actually a beautiful day. And, exposure, there we go. It's a beautiful day today. And the weather is actually warm-ish. It's like a cold warm, you know, like a 40 degree type of warm. But yeah, so I'm gonna get ready because I should really get going to class now. Okay, maybe so late to class. But last thing I want to say is that I'm gonna wear this coat my mom gave me, so yeah.
Today's gonna be a great day. I can feel it in my bones. Like I'm so, this is honestly probably one of the most exciting birthdays, and it just began, that I've had in a very, very long time. Actually, probably my whole life. Yeah, because 20, I was in quarantine. Well, no, 20, I was in California. Okay, no, take that back. But 21, I was in quarantine. And 22, here we are now, woo! Okay, let's go. Actually, before we go, last few touch-ups. Where am I gonna put you? On this plant holder. Okay, because I'm too lazy to put you on my tripod. Hair oil, my Gisu. Of course. Rub. And put. My favorite product from them is hair perfume. This smells so good. And honestly, smells like, I don't know, honey and wonderful good things in life. That's like the most vague description ever, but it smells really good, and like I think everyone will like it. It's very floral, very girly, if that makes any sense. So if you're looking for more like a masculine scent, that's not for you, but this smells so good. Okay, let's go now. great. How are you feeling, Anna?
Pretty good.
Great. Right.
It's my best friend's birthday.
Right.
And we're celebrating.
So we're at Tate, as Anna said. And she got me these flowers, which I'm so grateful for. They're so pretty. And we were just talking about, I feel like if you just like carry a bouquet of flowers, you just feel so much better about the day. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So thank you again. I really appreciate it. Also, I'm going to skip class as well.
Ooh.
I'm skipping my futures and options class, which I don't know if it's a good idea or not, but do I care?
You don't want, it's your birthday, you deserve to live.
Exactly, and the classes are recorded, and like,
so,
it's
yeah,
fine.
Yeah, it's fine.
It's fine.
Oh, shit.
That did not work out.
Oh god, that was not satisfying.
I hope you got that
on. Hi, everyone. So, here at the Commons. It's a very beautiful day. And I was thinking it's a beautiful day because it's my birthday, obviously. Like, no, I'm just kidding. But actually, no, I'm not.
No, you're not. It really
is. Because it's March 2nd. I was going to tell you guys what we plan to do later tonight. So we're going to this restaurant called Mario. It's very pretty. I'm super excited. But before we do that, I'm going to... Anna has class around like at 2. And then, so I'm going to go head over to Newbury.
Ooh.
I'm gonna go shop for my party attire, my party on Saturday. Yeah, and then I also plan to probably buy a boba tea, because why not?
Yeah. Yay!
Oh, then I have to film some more content for another company, but that's fine, we got it. And then do homework, so I don't have to do it tonight.
Fun.
I still got that.
Fun.
But yes. So, gonna enjoy this day, and again, we'll just keep going and see what the next part of my day brings. But yeah, flowers!
Hi everyone, I'm currently back home. I just got back. I walked all the way from like downtown to Back Bay, and it was a beautiful, wonderful walk because it's just such a pretty day, and it's like fairly warm. And I swear to God, it's because it's my birthday. Anyways. And now all my friends know how much I love flowers. Like, even though I have quite the black thumb when it comes to keeping up with plants, I got these 2 flower bouquets and I feel so happy, and flowers just give me happiness. Like, they give me so much serotonin, it hurts in a good way. But yeah, and then I am actually also baking something real quick for a video for a company. So it's my birthday, I have to do a lot of work still before we can have some fun later tonight, but I'm also very excited. And yeah, so it is now nighttime and Elaine and I are getting ready to go out to dinner tonight. I'm gonna show you guys my little makeup routine. I'm just kidding. Well, also not, because I am. What? Eye cream. Put this one on my eyelids as well. Okay, Vaseline. Honestly, helps with every single thing. And touch that up a little bit. This one I think is the fun part. I like putting concealer on because it's like so fascinating how it hides all, you know, skin imperfections. And I'm using the Ultra Repair. Okay, this is not really foundation. This is a tinted moisturizer. It's SPF 30. I'm gonna just go around. Then my favorite concealer, which is the Tarte Creaseless Concealer. And voila, that is my minimal glam look. Now for hair, it's already kind of done, but I want to curl it a little bit more and get it a little bit more voluminous because it lost some of that during the day. So I'm gonna go do that.
playing The Weeknd right now. Ilda, we're playing The Weeknd right now. The Weeknd, we're playing him right now.
Are you a Weeknd fan?
Hi everyone, so it is the next day. I had so much fun last night. That was a really great time. I made those reservations like a month in advance because I get booked so quickly there. It's a really beautiful place, and yeah. But this was the first time on the actual day of my birthday, I spent it with friends and not family. It's crazy. I'm gonna spend my birthday celebration with my family though on Friday, so tomorrow. I'm very excited. And yeah, but something about yesterday, just like being with like a, you know, your group of friends, going to like a nice restaurant, and just like being able to like afford to eat at a nice restaurant or just do whatever you want, like being old enough to do all those things, it hits different and really makes me not miss being a teenager. Because yeah, again, teenage me was not making any money. Well, actually no, I had my first job as a temp job. I made like no money there, but it was a job nonetheless. Oh, another thing I also wanted to mention was that I kind of had like a revelation not too long ago that I realized that I want to cut as much alcohol from my life as I can, because it sounds like I'm an alcoholic. I'm not. The thing is that ever since like I turned 21, or actually no, ever since I went to college, I always just drank socially, but you know, people are like, oh, let's get drunk. And I'm like, okay. And I like, even though I hate the way alcohol tastes, like I'm just like who like, actually first of all, who likes the taste of alcohol? But also, I hated the way it would make me feel the next day because I have terrible hangovers. And I'm like, was it worth it? I don't know. And obviously everything in moderation. But again, I don't like alcohol enough to have it in moderation. It's kind of like I don't have it at all or I go hardcore. So, yeah, that's the thing. Last night I ordered a virgin cocktail. It was not very good at all, actually. It just tasted like bitter pineapple juice and it was warm. And it wasn't good. Yeah, now we're gonna, let's go study. Because if I'm gonna keep talking, I'm just talking as much as I can so I don't have to do it. Okay, I'm gonna turn off the camera now. Okay, I'll see you when I'm getting ready. Oh, one more thing too. Really exciting news, though, I have to mention this. The Weeknd finally dropped his tour dates and I plan to get tickets tomorrow.
I've been anticipating this for such a long time and it's gonna be on July 21st, so.
All right, guys, I'm gonna head to class now and then after that, we're gonna go to my friend Ella's apartment. Chill there for a bit and then go pregame at our other friend's apartment. Yeah, exactly. So, gonna do that and see you there.
I see you drowning in the bright lights, darkness shining bright. I see every eyes on you.
Hi everyone, it's the next day, and honestly, that was so weird because that was like the first time I've like been to a club 100% sober. So I have an exam. I didn't get to go to bed until like 3, and my exam is at 10:05. So this is a great definition of being in your 20s in school, is you go party, next day you have an exam, and yeah, that's just how life goes. But I am ready and I'm excited. Also gonna go home today, like home, missing my parents, have dinner with them. And yeah, I miss my parents a lot. And so seeing them again at home will be really refreshing. So yeah, my dad also just got out of the hospital, so it's gonna be really nice to see him and see how he's doing. So yeah, let's go to class. This is the fit. It's super fashionable. I'm wearing like these kind of like, yeah, Cali boot jeans and just a really oversized comfy sweater. Look at my two tripods. It's like, these are like my two main bitches. Like, I swear to God, I don't know what I'd do without them. Although I need to get a new one of this. Okay, anyways, let's go.
Hello everyone, we are officially back home.
I have not been back home since break, so it feels really nice to be here again and, you know, have all the free food in the world. I came home and my dad surprised me with cookies. This recipe is like super sacred to like my family because these take, again, like 24 hours to make because you let the dough rest. And also whenever you make chocolate chip cookies, we always, always make these ones.
Gonna do like a little food porn thing. Okay, here's the cookie and
okay. I always love the center parts of cookies because that's when like they're the softest and gooeyest. Like, yeah. Is that satisfying? I don't really know, but it tastes good. Honestly, it's just so nice to be home. And also, by the way, I woke up this morning. I felt fine. I mean, yeah, I was tired. I only slept for like 4 hours, took my exam. Then I was like, I'm fine, I'm great. But then when I was on the train and I was just like listening to music, oh my God, did I just want to sleep and like pass out. But I knew if I did, then I would miss my stop and that's not worth it. So we can save sleep for tonight, but right now I'm gonna enjoy this cookie, spend time with my family. It's nice to be home. And yeah, I love our kitchen. I miss cooking in this kitchen because my kitchen back at my apartment sucks. I hate cooking in that little shoebox, but I mean, I can't have everything. So it's whatever, it's okay. I'll see you guys when I see you.
Lola, I miss you so much. I did, Lola. I got your gift. I want to say thank you so much. Say hi, Dad. Hey, Mom.
Hi.
Yeah, ooh, no, I look way too. Why is it overexposure? Currently watching the Weeknd Dawn FM experience on Amazon Prime, forcing my mom to watch it with me. Aha. Speaking of the Weeknd, guess who got tickets to see him on July 21st? I did! Woo! I'm so excited. I cannot wait. It feels so surreal. I'm pretty sure my number one Spotify artist and like Spotify wrap up of this year will probably be the Weeknd. Oh my God, I'm so excited. Dreams do come true, huh, Mom?
I hear the secrets that you keep when you talk. The secrets that you keep.
Whoa!
Officially, this is how it looks, right? Got the pizzas, whatever. But this room, oh my God, it looks so good. Like, I can't even fathom how good it looks. Like, look at that, it's amazing. Oh my gosh. I'm very, very excited. And the person who did this all, Elena.
Dancing queen. Happy birthday, babe.
Thank you. Okay.
Top, Zara. Skirt, Zara. Shoes, let me be honest, I don't know.
Me neither.
The Weeknd says baby girl a lot.
I know he does, right? Woo!
So last night was pretty wild. It was super fun. I had such a great time. I'm cleaning up the remnants of a party. My cousin and her friend, they went to get some breakfast. My friends just left as well. They stayed at my place, also to clean this up. But honestly guys, this has probably been the best birthday I've had, like ever. Hi everyone, so I'm gonna be honest with you, I forgot to film an ending for this video like I did with my other video. And because I had work that day and I told myself I'd film when I come back from work, but I just ended up passing out because I was so tired. So here's the ending. I just wanted to say, also yeah, I'm on my bed right now. Very, very chillaxed spot. You're on my nightstand right now. But I just wanted to say that I'm super, super thankful for all of my friends who have just provided me with nothing but straight up happiness and, you know, just thankfulness and gratefulness. Because, you know, I think the biggest lesson I've also learned after turning 22 is that you should always choose quality friends over quantity, because those few friends, you know, will always make a positive impact in your life. And I believe your life should always be filled with authenticity, as hard as it is. I mean, I'm still working hard on that. But I just also want to thank my family for being the best, especially my cousin Elena, who literally did so many surprises for me and did so much for me, even before my birthday. So I love her so much if you're watching this. And then also want to thank my parents. It's like I'm winning an award. I know, it's just, this birthday meant a lot to me, sentimentally and emotionally. So I also want to thank my parents for, you know, just supporting me whatever I do in life, and for giving me, again, a really great birthday, because I haven't seen them in a while. And fortunately, I was able to spend my birthday with my sister. She's in California right now studying, so yeah, can't see her, but I love you, Ate, if you're watching this. Speaking of watching this, this has been like my longest video on my channel. So if you made it this far, kudos to you. That's a long ass time, but thank you guys so much for watching. Again, this video wasn't really supposed to provide any value in the sense, you know, where it was kind of just for me to look back on, you know, when I did turn 22, once, you know, I'm older, and be like, oh, I was just a 22-year-old baby, you know? And, you know, especially like when I'm 40, oh my God. I'm sorry, I know this video is super late. It's just because I've been filming like so many other side projects. You guys probably won't be able to see some of them, because, you know, they're just, it's other things that I can't really talk about just yet. That sounds really sketchy. It's not, it's just, you know, confidential stuff, you know? But also, I do see your guys' messages on the videos you'd like me to create. I promise I will create them. I just have to get these little priorities out of the way, but I do see them and I will do it, I promise. Especially a video about Suffolk University. But yeah, okay, this will finally be the ending. Thank you again for watching. Love you all so much, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.